Namaskar, this is Sunilee Jani Pawar welcoming you all to Planet to Soul Astrology. Before starting my video, I would like to thank you all for subscribing my channel, for liking my videos and giving me good comments as well as your suggestions. Whoever have not yet subscribed my channel, but I know they are watching my videos, so I again ask them all, do subscribe my channel. You know, asking for the subscription is always a motivational point for me, is always a token of appreciation for me that yes, people are liking my videos or people are subscribing my channel and all that. It is a type of getting an award from you all people, and this motivates me to give you more and more. So please ask your friends also, whoever are interested in astrology, to subscribe the channel and give comments and your suggestions. So today we will be talking about Mars and Ketu conjunction, which is already in transit. On 2nd of May 2018, Mars has entered into its exalted sign Capricorn, Makar Rashi, okay, where Ketu was already there from last year. So Mars and Ketu. Mars, as you all know, is an aggressive hot planet. It has energy into it, and it is said that Ketu acts like a Mars. Why it is said like that, that Ketu acts like a Mars only, Mangal ke jaisa kaam karta hai? Because Ketu also have same aggression. See, when Amrit Manthan took place, at that time Rahu was separated and Ketu was also separated. So below neck, to dhad ka jo hai, means below neck portion till the leg is of Ketu. So it's always in a shaky mode. Ketu is a tail, that is why all four legs animals or four leg any non-living things also we consider as a Ketu. Why? Because they are always shaking. Tail is always shaking for the animals. So that is why we have given the name of Ketu specifically for dog, because dog shakes the his tail at the most. Coming back to Mars and Ketu yuti. So now it's a good for all of us as well as bad for all of us. Any planet whenever get transit in our chart, definitely we are going to get both the fruits at positive side as well as negative side. But then it depends on the strength of our planetary position in our chart. If in my chart Mars is in very good strength, no matter wherever it will transit, it will definitely give me good fruits. If Mars is natural benefic planet, or it is a yoga karaka planet in my chart, so definitely it will give me very good result. For example, if I have agni tattva, fiery lagna or fiery moon sign, so definitely Mars will be benefic for me to give me the fruits. Then again I have to see that what place Mars is transiting in my chart, which house Mars is transiting in my chart. But basically, even though to be very honest, I don't feel that Ketu acts like a Mars. I have not seen it working. Whoever has seen it working, so maybe they got the experience, but as per my experience, I don't see that Mars acts like. Yes, Ketu has a tendency of aggression. Ketu has the tendency of immediately giving the result or cutting off. Mars is also cutting off, but Mars is energy, whereas Ketu is detachment. Okay, so unless and until Ketu gets energy from any Shubha planet or any benefic planet, definitely it won't give its fruit at the full extent. Now Mars and Ketu, they are I think 3 degree away from each other. Mars is around 12 degrees and Ketu is also around, Mars is around 15 degrees and Ketu is around 12 degrees, and now at this moment they are in yuti, they are in conjunction. So this is the period maximum effects will be seen. Mars is energy, as I said. Mars is aggression. Mars is the hastiness. Mars is giving the fruits at its fullest. Mars is giving the result on this spot. Whereas Ketu is detaching the people, detaching the events, detaching the things on this spot without giving prior notice. This is the fruit of Ketu. Wherever Ketu is placed in your chart, it will show your lingering desires, or it will show your desires towards that house significance. In my last session of Rahu Ketu also, I have told this. Whoever had not seen the video, just go through my Rahu Ketu video. Many things I have told about these two shadowy planets. So wherever Ketu is placed, it will always show the linger, or it will always show the need of that, or urge for getting that house significance. Even though person has everything, but still person will feel, no, I am lacking in this thing. Say for example, if Ketu is posited in your ninth house in the chart. So ninth house we see for father also. Ninth house we see for pilgrimage also. Ninth house we see from bathing in the holy rivers also. And ninth house is higher education. Ninth house is tours and travels. Everything is ninth house. So here a person will think that I am getting less love from my father, or I have lack of father's bliss in my life, or I wanted to do higher education. Even though person is double graduate, person will think, no, I need something more. I want to research something more, or I could not go to this pilgrimage. Even though apart from out of all his society friends, this person may have visited many pilgrimages, but still that person will think, no, something is lacking for me. Same way in second house also, if Ketu is posited, person will always have a urge to earn the money. Person will always think that, no, I am lacking love in the family, something is lacking. Or in the 12th house, if Ketu is posited in your chart, they have urge for the medication or meditation, both. Or they will always feel that I need hospitalization, or I am suffering from certain disease, I have to go to doctor. Even though nothing like that is happening in their life, but still they will think, no, I need something more. It is an open sky. They will think, no, I have to achieve, or I have to awaken my energy, and I have to do this. So Ketu is always pending desires in that house. In whatever house your Ketu, even though your natal Ketu, whatever house it is posited in, it shows that in last life you had pending desires towards that house. For example, again, if Ketu is posited in the 8th house, so this person's pending desire was towards the occult, towards the research, towards the spouse family, any Rina, to pay off to the spouse's family. That is why this birth Ketu has come in 8th house. And also this such people will not have very good connectivity with in-laws. Yeah, unless and until any benefic planet is with it or aspect is on it. Coming back to Mars and Ketu conjunction. See, basically Mars is a, I will not say it is a Shubha planet as per the qualification of the planets. It is considered as a strong planet in the chart. It is not sattvic planet. It is tamasic planet. It is kshatriya by nature. It is a soldier by nature. So it indicates bravery. It indicates on the spot fruit, instant fruit. And Ketu at that same time, it is detaching the Mars from giving its fruit on the spot. So whatever things are coming till your mouth, the Ketu will act like snatching away the fruit from you, and you may feel bad about it because Mars is very strong. Mars will think, okay, if Ketu is not allowing, I will not give the fruits unless I become alone or unless I leave this zodiac sign. So this Mars is going to be retrograde also, and it is going to remain in the same house for more 6 months, that is till September. This Mars is going to remain with Ketu in all of us chart. Now, how it will act for all of us? As I said, that fruits will be given, fruits will not be given. If in your chart, this yuti or this conjunction is in your lagna, in your ascendant, definitely that will be Capricorn ascendant or moon. You should not get confused that from moon chart I am talking or from ascendant I am talking. You have to consider ascendant as well as moon. And if you have different ascendant and different moon sign, if you have Capricorn ascendant and if you have a Leo moon sign, so definitely for Leo also this prediction will be applicable, and for Capricorn also this prediction will be applicable. And whatever prediction is more attached to you, more working for you, you have to go for that, and you need not get confused about it. So if this conjunction is in your ascendant, then definitely your thought process will be very aggressive, you will become very hot tempered, you will become detached also, very moody by nature, unnecessary on the things, you will get angry, you may have a difference of opinion with your partner, with your spouse, and due to any uncertainty of thoughts, uncertainty of the decision, you may lose very important things in your life. At the same time, energy level will be so much that there is a need of drinking water constantly for you, which will really help you a lot, and it will help you to energize, or it will help you to neutralize the energy of your hotness with the water. So definitely you have to drink more of water. The good part is that if at all it is transiting over your moon, Capricorn moon in ascendant, or at all if moon is having aspect on this Mars, then definitely some financial gain is also expected. You may think whatever plans are in your mind, this is the time when this will come into an action. If this conjunction is in your second house, in your chart, whatever, if you are having Sagittarius ascendant or Sagittarius moon, it will be in your second house. So second house is of our family. So here some sort of property issues may take place, or some say small clashes with the family members, with your elder uncle, elder auntie, elder brother. Some problems may take place, some eye issues, some tooth problem also, you have to go for the medication, and maybe some financial loss is also indicated in your chart. The good part is that you may try to invest money in some property with the help of your family. If this conjunction is in your third house, that is for Scorpio ascendant or Scorpio moon people, third house is benefic planet for Mars, because third house is of bravery. 3, 6 and 11 house is said good for the Mars because it is a three shadiyadi bhav. So third house is also karaka for Mars. So here your actions will take place in a good manner, your mind will be in a good thought process. If Mercury is also in good position in your chart, definitely this conjunction will give you motion. Ketu will give you motion. Ketu is karaka of motion. Ketu will never allow you to sit at one place if posited in the third house, or now in the third house in transit. It will make you travel from here and there, or it will make change in your profession, in your work, in your braveries also. New ideas will be implemented. Also, the relationship with your siblings may affect, but you will get help from your siblings also. If this Yuti, Mars Ketu is in your fourth house, I would advise do not invest immediate money to any property, because Mars is good to invest the property, but Ketu here may lengthen the procedure or may stop the procedure in between, or some sort of troubles may get created. This Yuti, if transiting from your fourth house, that is if you have Capricorn sign in your fourth house, that is for Tula ascendant, okay, for Libra people, then here what will happen, this will become your second lord also, and this will become your seventh lord also. It is coming in the fourth house. So here family members, your spouse will be detached from you, or they may go for a long travel, or you may have to shift to another place. But unless and until it is necessary, it is must, I would advise not to shift to any another new place, which may give you troubles. Also, Mars Ketu here may give you weird dreams, lack of sleep, lack of peace of mind, less of connectivity with your mother also. You may have difference of opinion with your mother also. If this conjunction is from your fifth house, so here what Virgo people, if it is in your fifth house, then what will happen, you may have some difference of opinion with your children's. You have to send your children out for study purpose, or they have to travel elsewhere. Love affairs, whoever are having, may get affected. There may be some break in the love affairs. There may be some break in the education also. If you are a technical student, if you are studying engineering or any technical things, computers, so there may be some stream changing for you. Mars and Ketu in the fifth house. Again, if you are trying for share market, or if you are investing money for mutual funds, this price may come down. This may also take place. Ketu will detach the fruits from that house, and you will start lingering for that house significance. You will start thinking more about the share. You will start thinking more about your children's. You will start thinking more about going away from the house, because at the same time, for Virgo people, Mars is your eighth lord also. So eighth lord is coming in the fifth house. So with the your spouse family also, you may have difference of opinion during this period. People having this conjunction in the sixth house of your chart, so when it will happen, in the Leo ascendant or Leo moon, the Capricorn sign will come in your sixth house. So sixth house is again a Karaka house. Here you may get some post position, or your workload may get increased. Your subordinates or your sahakaris, whoever are working with you, may work under you. You get some power, but at the same time you may have some detachment, or you may have some quarrels, or you may have some deteriorated relationship with your subordinates, because Ketu is again with the Mars. At the same time, maybe you change your job also, or new opportunities are waiting for you. Ketu will make you travel, or whoever are trying, going to abroad or going to another state, this is the correct opportunity for them to go out, because for Leo people, this is the fourth lord, okay, coming in the sixth house. So what it indicates, that for work you have to go away from the house, and your ninth lord coming in the sixth house. So your fortune is in your work. So definitely this you should try for another job also. If this conjunction is taking place in your seventh house, that is for Cancer people, Cancer moon sign, 7th house is of our spouse, 7th house is of our partnership, 7th house we see for travels also. So if this conjunction is in the 7th house because of Mars, because Mars is a quarrelsome planet, Mars is a soldier, Mars is a hot temper, and Mars is a desire. Mars is, I want this stubbornness. Mars is the stubbornness. Whatever you think, you get stubborn more and more. If this 7th house Mars and Ketu, your spouse will become more stubborn towards his or her needs. Maybe lack of physical attention towards each other will take place. This Ketu may detach your spouse from you, or you have to go for long travels keeping your spouse away from you. And whoever are on the verge of separation or any disputes are taking place, it is advisable, do not take any strong decision during this period. Just wait for good transit, wait and watch, things will improve in future. Okay, in partnership business also, do not immediately take any decision, no, I don't want to work with this person. This is a time for you where you have to think 100 times before taking any decision, because 10th lord is coming in your 7th house and your 5th lord is coming in your 7th house. So here, even many who are going for the love marriage or who are going for the marriage purpose, because of this Mars and Ketu, it may get delayed, but do not worry, things are going to be best. Once the October month comes, Jupiter will be transiting from your 5th house, so this will be the best position for you. Before that also, need not at all worry, just do good, so everything will be good for you. If Mars and Ketu are transiting from your 8th house, okay, that is for Mithuna people, for Gemini ascendant and Gemini moon sign. So for Gemini, this is the 6th lord and 11th lord positing in the 8th house, which we say is a not very good position, because for Mithuna people, the Mars is not natural benefic or Yoga Karaka planet. Okay, Yoga Karaka planet must be in the Kendra or in the Trikon, but here Mars sign is coming in the Trik Bhava and in Trishadyadi Bhava. So Mars and Ketu positive in the 8th house may create grumbles in your mind. You may be of wavery mind. Any legal matters which you are facing, or any legal matter which you are going to apply, you may get fail into it, or the result may get extended, or immediate result, or cut off of the relationship from your spouse's family may take place. Yes, the good sign is whoever are into research, whoever are into healing, whoever are into occult, definitely this is the good period. Mars is the energy, Ketu is the detachment, Mars is the stubborn yoga, hatha yoga. So this is the best time. You must do the best of meditation, because in your 5th house, Jupiter is always there in transit. So this will really help you a lot. So this Jupiter and Mars will be in Kendra to each other. Also Jupiter and Ketu will be in 4-10 position to each other, because Jupiter from Mars and Ketu will come into 10th house. So definitely whoever are in occult, their work, their practice will increase. They must increase their energy level. So this is a good sign for Gemini people. Also travels are indicated for Gemini people. Health wise, they may suffer some chest related problems, some neck related problems, shoulder pain they may have. So this is the way they have to take care of their health. If this transit is taking place from your 9th house, which is for Taurus people, Vrushabh Lagna or Vrushabh moon sign, if this Mars and Ketu are posited in your 9th house, so this 9th house is third from your spouse's house. So you may have difference of opinion with your say brother-in-law or sister-in-law. At the same time, I would advise, do not start any new good things during this period Mars and Ketu, because Mars always give late results in the 9th house. Mars will try to burn the ninth house spirituality, ninth house effect. Mars will try to overcome, because in the natural zodiac, Jupiter is there in the ninth house. So Mars will try to overpower that Jupiter's power, and as well as Ketu is there. So this period is best for the pilgrimage visit. This period is best for making the platform for any new thing. But new thing must be started after September month, or when the Jupiter will transit from your 7th house. This will be the best position for you to start new partnership business or any new ventures you can start. No doubt this Mars and Ketu in 9th will give you many travels, the long distance travel, people going for education purpose, because 12th Lord is coming in your 9th house. So foreign travels are also indicated for Taurus people, and your fortune will definitely give you strength. For Taurus people, Mars is also 7th Lord. So 7th Lord is coming in the fortune house. So your spouse, your wife or your husband will be favorable for you for enhancing your fortune. So do not forget to make your spouse happy. So start giving her or him gifts. So this will work a lot for you. If this transit is taking place from your 10th house, that is for Mesh people, that is for Aries people, if this Mars and Ketu in the 10th house, this will definitely give you extra power to work. You may get promotion, you may get transfers also, or you may have to travel for any training purpose, because Mesh Rashi, the ascendant Lord itself is coming in the 10th house, as well as 8th Lord coming in the 10th house. Do not start any new things at present, but if you are already working in any organization, this is the best period to start the new things, because Mars is in the best position in the 10th house, being the ascendant Lord. So your mind will start thinking more and more about the work. At the same time, you have to travel. As I said, this is the good position, being the 8th Lord in 10th house, and Ketu is also there. So Ketu will keep you in motion. Ketu will give you new ideas. At the same time, you may get detached from your old employer or old subordinate, and you may meet your new ones. If this transit is taking place from your 11th house, okay, so what will happen? That is a Pisces Lagna, Pisces Ascendant or Pisces Moon. So this is your second Lord coming in the 11th house, as well as your 9th Lord coming in the 11th house. So what it will happen, what it will give, that your family will be favorable for you. 11th house is Trishadi Adibhav, good for Ketu as well as good for Mars also. Again, your fortune Lord is in the Labhasthana, so whatever you will think, you will get it. Just try to implement your ideas in a right way. This is the best period. Implementation will be best, even though people having retrogression Mars in their own chart. People may ask this question for me, what will happen when this will become retrograde? If in your chart Mars is in good strength, definitely this Mars will give you good result. Only thing, be spiritual, awaken your spiritual element within you. Your elder brother, your elder uncle, your sister-in-law is always there to help you for Pisces people. If this transit is taking place in your 12th house, okay, so for Aquarius people, Kumbh Rashi, Kumbh Lagna. So what result it will give you? This is your third Lord in the 12th house, as well as your 10th Lord is in the 12th house. So here your parakrama may get wasted. Okay, whatever work, whatever urge or whatever things you are doing to enhance your third house, enhance your 10th house, to enhance the relationship with your subordinates, it may get wasted. At the same time, if in your chart Mars is in good position, so definitely some good fruits are also indicated. It is also seen that you may have to travel internationally, because third Lord, being a house of journey, is coming in the 12th house. 10th lord being a house of profession is coming in the 12th house. So for work purpose you have to travel a lot. You may get some good perks or good respect, or people will acknowledge your work. This is also seen for Pisces people if Mars is in good position in your chart. So you need not at all worry about this Mars and Ketu. Only one remedy for all I will say, just visit Ganpati temple every day. If not possible every day, at least visit every Tuesday or every Wednesday also you can visit to Ganpati temple, and red flower if possible, or just make namaskaram to Ganpati Devata and just chant Om Gam Ganpate Namaha. This is the best remedy for all of us, and let us welcome this yuti in our chart. And I wish all the best all these 6 months. Go well for you and stay tuned with Planet to Soul Astrology. Namaskar.